Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome back to my channel. In this video we will discuss working concept, working principle of IGBT, inverter IGBT welding machine. If it is single phase or if it is three phase, the working or the main circuit will remain same. No difference between single phase and three phase. Let me explain single phase. We have phase and neutral at this point. Then we have a power switch. Sometime here will be a MCB, circuit breaker. From circuit breaker, when we will turn on, the voltage will pass to this bridge rectifier. Here AC, in the output we have DC voltage. The positive side is here, the ground side is negative side is here. So the positive voltage, now we have one relay. This path is open. The current will pass through this NTC. Why this NTC is used? Because we have main capacitors. These are about 470 microfarad, 450 microfarad or plus. When these are empty, there is no charge on the capacitors, what will happen? They will need more current. That is called surge current. That is instantaneous load on the rectifiers to protect expected damage, because this time when the capacitor is discharged, it works as a short circuit because it intends to draw maximum current. So to protect from any damage, there is NTC, negative temperature coefficient resistor, is installed here. The capacitor will charge slowly because it is a high amount of microfarads, so the current will pass through this path and it will charge. When it will reach at a specific level, might be 150 volts, 100 volts, these voltage are same time are reaching at this transformer. What is that? That is low voltage power supply. The positive voltage are reaching here at this winding, and then there is a Smps controller. It may be any number, SDC or tinny switch, link switch, or what's a wiper series, any IC will hear, and it will switch, it will make pulses like this between ground and positive. Here is positive voltage, so it will make switching at a specific frequency, about 60 hertz, 120 kilohertz, whatsoever. What is the design? Every inverter circuit, every welding machine might be have a different design. Maybe from the same manufacturer you will find different IC, and it will make switching. When it will make switching, we will find a voltage output that approximately 25 volt. When these voltage will reach in the output, capacitor will charge. The same time these voltage will make interlock to this relay. This relay will turn on, and same time these voltage will also reach to this fan. So fan will start up. These heat sink, these diodes are installed on heat sink. So for cooling, and for cooling of the IGBT heat sink module, so fan will start up, and this relay will turn on. The voltage pass from this point directly to the capacitor. First, when it was discharged, to protect from surge current, protect from inrush current, the current was passing through this resistor. Now the capacitors are at maximum level, so there is no surge current. So now the regular current will flow from this relay points. Now we have voltage here. It was the single phase. If it is three phase, this rear circuit will change. Here we have three phase circuit breaker, and here we have six diodes. In two phase we have four diodes, in three phase we have six diodes. Every phase will be rectified, and we will find voltage in the output, and the next circuit will remain same. These positive voltage are reached at this IGBT, and this IGBT. Two IGBTs, sometimes four IGBT, two or four, whatsoever. It depends upon the wattage, the output current of the welding machine. If we have four, another set will same in parallel. And this voltage, 25 volt, will regulate it through a voltage regulator or some zener regulator. So we will find 15 volt and 5 volt. 15 volt for control card, for oscillator card, and 5 volt in that case if we have panel meter, display meter, current display meter. If we have current display meter, that time we will have 5 volt. Otherwise maybe 15 volt and 25 volt. If there is no display meter, just only 15 volt and 25 volt. Now come to this point. Positive is here, ground is here, and the common emitter and collector of both IGBTs is connected to a winding of main transformer, power transformer, the output transformer. The positive end, one end is here, second end of the transformer will connect it to two capacitors, ceramic capacitors about 4.5 to 6.87 microfarad, but it is non-polar capacitor, ceramic capacitor. So this capacitor is ceramic capacitor, this capacitor is ceramic capacitor. So we have IGBTs. These IGBTs will not work now. First come to this point. These 15 volt will reach to this inverter circuit. This inverter circuit is any IC. This comes in universal module, a standalone module. It takes 15 volt, and we adjust our required current through a potentiometer. Sometimes this potentiometer is connected to directly 15 volts. Sometimes our zener voltage, a reference voltage, are applied to one point, the second point is ground. So we apply a taped voltage to this 3525 or TL494, any IC which is whatsoever here, to non-inverting input. That is our requirement. For example, we tape 1 volt, I need 100 ampere current. When we adjust potentiometer, we apply a voltage level, we can say it is 1 volt. 1 volt will transform to 100 ampere. It is translated voltage. I rotated it until the center, that means I need 100 ampere. 200 ampere is full clockwise rotation, 0 ampere is here at full counterclockwise. So I set to mid position, that means 100 ampere. I will apply 1 volt here. Here we applied some voltage, ground. So with respect to ground, 1 volt is here. So this IC will start switching. It will start oscillation. For example, its oscillation frequency, because it have RTCT, timing resistor, timing capacitor, it is frequency adjustment. So it will start switching at 45 kilohertz. For example, its duty cycle is 25%. It will start switching. It will drive. Sometime it have transistors, two transistors, sometime here is MOSFET, sometime here is driver IC, MOSFET driver IC, for example 4688 or any other IC which will drive this transformer. So our signal will reach here, these will switch to this transformer, and we have inverted output in the secondary. This signal transformer, it have primary and two secondaries. So both secondaries are opposite to each other. So we will find a gate drive pulse through this resistor diode network. We will give pulses at the gates. This pulse will drive this gate to emitter. Gate to emitter. So this pulse will drive this gate, and this pulse will drive this gate. So both, as I told, the both windings are opposite to each other, and the output signal at these points, pin 1 and pin 3, are opposite to each other. If one is high, the second signal is low. So one IGBT will fire, the other will cut off. When this will cut off, at this time the second IGBT will high. So one will on, second will off. This will off, this will on. So it will work opposite to each other. How these are working? For example, this IGBT is off. This time this IGBT is conducting. Positive voltage will switch through this IGBT. So this current positive will flow from this IGBT, from this primary, and this time the current will flow this capacitor, because at high frequency the capacitor gives low resistance, capacitive reactance, so the current will pass to this negative terminal. So our this capacitor will discharge in the winding from positive to this capacitor to negative terminal. Now the cycle changed. This IGBT will off, this IGBT will on. When this will on, the negative side, negative current will start from this end to IGBT to the winding through this capacitor to the positive terminal of the capacitor. First the current flow from positive to negative, and now from negative current direction will change, so our switching cycle will keep changing through the signal from this IC. This transformer pulse forming network, and we will take output voltage in the secondaries of the power transformer. So power transformer will apply voltage to these rectifiers. In some welding machines we will find four rectifier diodes molded back, like D92-02 or -20, or sometime 20 ampere rectifiers. Sometime we find 30 ampere rectifiers. If it is 20, maybe it is used 20 ampere rectifier, maybe it is using four rectifiers. If it is 30 ampere rectifier, maybe he will use three rectifiers. So we will take positive voltage in the output. Both secondaries, the secondary is center taped, and the center tape will accept it as a common. So common winding, common point will give negative voltage through a shunt resistor that is used to measure the current. How much current will flow from here in this portion through this electrode and through the welding terminal? So load current will be calculated from here. As I discussed, I applied 1 volt to this IC as a reference. That is my requirement. When current will flow, it will cause to drop voltage to this resistor, this shunt. So one end is grounded because I applied ground to 1 volt. So one end of this shunt is grounded. The second end is connected to this oscillator IC. When it will receive 1 volt, I requested 1 volt, and the output current is 100 ampere. I requested 100 ampere, so I applied 1 volt. The output current is 100 ampere, so drop voltage is 1 volt. So 1 volt will reach here, so this IC will set its duty cycle at that point. The electrode, it need more current, but this IC will not allow to flow the current more than 100 ampere by limiting its duty cycle. If I set to 150 ampere, so at that time, for example, I am giving 1.5 volt to non-inverting input. So it will increase. First it was giving 1 volt at 100 ampere. Now I set the potentiometer more clockwise to take 150 ampere. So it will increase the duty cycle to give us more current until it will receive 1.5 volt at this terminal, at this pin. When the both voltage will equal in the inverting and non-inverting input, at that time it will stable its duty cycle and it will fix it. The machine will running at that point. Then there is a temperature sensor which is connected to the same heat sink where the IGBTs are connected. The temperature sensor is connected to heatsink. So it will give feedback to this IC. For example, the temperature reaches at 90 degrees centigrade and we connected 90 degrees centigrade temperature sensor. At 90 degrees centigrade, it will turn off this machine. It will turn off switching. The other circuit will remain working. The fan will working. When it will cool down, it becomes at 60 degrees centigrade. At that time, the machine will turn on again automatically through this temperature sensor. So this machine have this facility over temperature. So overcurrent is sensed here. In any case, for example, our rectifier is short and there is uncontrolled current. I ask 100 ampere, but this circuit have no control. Why? Maybe any short circuit due to any reason. I am taking 200 ampere instead of 100 ampere. So here is sometime LM339, LM358, LM158, 258, anything whatsoever. So our required current and flowing current will monitored. If our flowing current is more than the required current, that time overcurrent indication will turn on. There is LED. So this operational amplifier or comparator will turn on this LED that there is overcurrent. So this overcurrent occurs in case of any short circuit in any component. Some welding machines have MOSFETs. The same place, IGBT, if there is two MOSFETs or three or four, five, six set in parallel. So these MOSFETs will in parallel. These will work instead of these. If it is using IGBT or if it is using MOSFET, the circuit will remain same. I hope so, friends, this video is good for you. If it is informative, give a thumb up. And if you have not subscribed my channel, subscribe it. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.